I have always wanted to make a video on this song. It's one of the hardest videos because it's one of the most beloved songs of all time, and yet it's also one of the most hated, or kind of most hated songs. And see, you're probably like, well, who cares? You probably love the song, so, you know, just talk about how much you love it. But it's a little bit more complicated than that. See, this song has managed to transcend and do so much than just be a song. It's influenced and been a part of ideologies, ways of thinking, culture, thought, everything. But here, let me start off by saying that I do love this song, and I love John Lennon. But my love for this song is probably not the same love that others have for it. See, there are people that love this song because it's beautiful. Which it is. Its chords and the piano part is one of the most beautiful things I've ever heard in my life. I remember listening to it when I was young, a young teen to be exact, and kind of air playing the piano part, and my dad caught me and he kind of smiled and gave a nice comment, and it was nice. The da 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 da, that fucking da da da, oh my fucking god, that's what makes the piano part so beautiful. It's the tension, the heart pull, the drama in that piano part. Da, da, da. The strings and the verses too are so nice. And I will say the piano as a whole in the song sounds so godlike. Pardon the pun. It's perfect, and when it envelops your ears at the start of the chorus, it brings me chills. And also, if you see that I'm like fucking glistening, it's not because I'm Edward, but because I have no AC right now in my house. Imagine there's no heaven. Imagine there's no country. It isn't hard. And the bridge of the song, or the post-chorus, or outro, or whatever it is, the chords there, along with the chorus, are just so painful, yet heartwarming to hear. Especially when you just think of, you know, John Lennon's death. The progression of them, the lyrics, and the melody, and the strings, just chilling perfection. You may say, now, there are also people who love the message of the song. And of course, we all know this song has been used many times, covered many times. It's used whenever there are talks about peace coming together. Most recently now, it was used in 2020 by a bunch of celebrities trying to bring some hope and light to the bleak times that people were faced with. So many, many people love the message of the song. But it's interesting, of course, when we see the lyrics of the song. Lyrics like, imagine there's no heaven, no religion, imagine no possessions, no greed, no hunger. It's utopia. It's this idea that we can achieve a perfect and harmonious world, not only by just having the will to do so, but by vanishing all the things that might divide us, like religion, countries, possessions. So here's the thing, that utopia is not possible. It will never be possible. And I'm an atheist. I do think that not believing in God can help us get closer to a better and more productive society in many ways, but that doesn't mean destroy the idea of God, or destroy the idea of righteousness or hierarchy. The idea of God is more important than the belief in God itself. It's why there are many religions, why there are many philosophies that come from religion. It's why I believe what I believe right now, and it's why atheism exists. And all of it, as a whole, has inevitably shaped our human consciousness. This utopia that John dreams of, it's beautiful, but it's also ironic. The song is called Imagine, almost as if John very much knows this utopia can only be a dream. That it's not possible. And it's funny because he says, imagine there's no heaven, yet what he's describing is just that. But the lyric imagine is really also used as a powerful and moving lyrical device to make the message of the song even stronger. Tell someone to imagine their innermost desires and just watch how happy and giddy they get. But this utopia, there will always be bad people in this world. Always. Where there is light, there is also dark. And life is more complicated than just ridding society of religion, countries, government, and possessions. Civilization is not by any means perfect now, and will never be, but it's way better than it has been in the past, and that is only possible partly because of the things John is wanting to eliminate. It's not religion, it's what it means for society. It's not government, money, or just possessions, it's what they mean for us as a society. Think of the horrible tragedies that have happened in the past. Certainly things have gotten a little better, right? And honestly, this is true even in one's individual life. But in order to succeed, in order to be great, there must be suffering. You cannot have one without the other. And a world where everyone is perfect, I swear to you and assure you, there will always be one person in the pack who will fucking ruin it for all of us. The song's collectivist message is an extremist one. Yeah, that's right. I said it. You gotta be more in the middle, okay? Too much of anything will kill you. But here's the thing. Even though I disagree with the philosophy of the song, that doesn't mean I don't respect it, number one. And second of all, it doesn't mean I still don't want to imagine it. The only reason I think the way that I do, that suffering will always be a constant in our world, but that it's necessary, is because I wish it wasn't that way. That's where it comes from. The only reason I don't believe in God is because I wish there was one. You don't fucking think that if I could snap my finger and have there be a God or a Superman that saves us from tragedy at all times, you think I wouldn't snap that fucking finger? I would. You bet that I would. You think I don't want a heaven when I die? And that's why I love this song. Because it's art. And art is what we use to make our dreams become as true as they possibly can. For those that hate this song because they disagree with it, and even to those that love this song because they agree with it, I say this, that's not the point. Don't be ashamed to sit back and enjoy this song because, let's be honest, you know you want to. And if this song can inspire you to be a better person in even some small way, then awesome. Just because the utopia that John wants is impossible doesn't mean that we still don't try achieving it. But also, I will also say this. The great thing about this is that utopia is impossible, no matter how hard we shoot for it, like perfection. And you know what that means? Unlimited potential. Unlimited opportunities to change the world in the smallest of ways. And that was sort of an idea from my beautiful girlfriend. In the biggest of ways, to better ourselves as much as possible. It doesn't hurt to dream. It just hurts that our dreams aren't reality. But that doesn't mean stop dreaming.